Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Okay, so we're telling the story. We're telling what happened in the Brihad Bhagavat Amrita.
我们前几天一直在上节课一直在讲《大伯加瓦坦甘露》这本书当中他所叙述的故事。
Maharaj Parikshit is giving teachings to his mother, Uttara.
Parikshit 大军正在教导他的母亲 Uttara.
And we're telling about, Maharaj Parikshit was telling his mother about one Brahmana who was not educated. He did not have any spiritual knowledge, but he was born in a Brahmana family.
Parikshit 大军跟他母亲 讲述了一位婆罗门，他虽然是婆罗门，但是却没有仔细的研读经典。
So somehow this Brahmana had been worshipping this deity of the wife of Lord Shiva.
这个婆罗门就在崇拜主Shiva的妻子，她这个女神的神像。
So this form of Lord Shiva's wife gave him a mantra, appeared to him in the dream, and gave him a mantra to chant.
主Shiva的妻子的这个神像就在婆罗门的梦中显现了，授予一个曼陀罗让他念诵。
And this mantra was to worship Madan Gopal.
这个曼陀罗是要崇拜Madan Gopal的。
So the Brahmana was chanting the mantra very faithfully.
那这个婆罗门就忠心地念诵着这个曼陀罗。
And because he was chanting the mantra, he became detached from his home and from his situation. And he did not have any wealth, he didn't have anything, so he began to travel.
念诵了这个曼陀罗之后，这婆罗门就开始不依附家庭以及他的这个房子，他也没有什么财产，然后他便开始漫游。
And we heard how he went to, first of all, he went to Ganga Sagar, where the Ganges flows into the ocean.
我们听到了，就是他先到了 Ganga Sagar， 也就是恒河入海的地方。
And there, at Ganga Sagar, he had associated with Brahmanas who were doing ritualistic ceremonies, karmakanda activities.
就在 Ganga Sagar这个地方，这贫穷的婆罗门就和那些在做着 karmakanda 织布的仪式，做仪式的那些当地的婆罗门们联谊。
So, at a certain point, he decided he wanted to live there, and he went to Kasi, and in Kasi means Banaras. He went to Banaras, a holy city on the bank of the Ganges.
到了一定的时间，这婆罗门决定离开这个 Ganga Sagar， 他决定去 Kasi， 也就是贝纳勒斯，是恒河岸边的一个城市。
And there he was associating with sannyasis.
他在这个地方和那当地的托钵僧们联谊。
But these sannyasis were all Mayavadi sannyasis, so they were speaking about the importance of liberation.
这些托钵僧全部是假象宗的托钵僧，嘴里谈论的全是解脱之类的话题。
And he was thinking, he was enjoying being with them, he enjoyed their company, and he would eat food with them, and he thought maybe he should also become a sannyasi.
贫穷的婆们们，这个婆罗门很就享受着跟这些托钵僧的联谊，他和他们一起吃住，他脑子中就有一个念头，也许我也应该当托钵僧了。
But Lord Shiva appeared to him in a dream and told him, "Don't worry about being trying to be a sannyasi. Just go to Mathura."
但是就在这时候，主 Shiva 显现在他就显现给他了，就告诉他，你不要太过于纠结是不是要当托钵僧，你去 Mathura。
Lord Shiva told him that if you go to Mathura, in Mathura you'll get everything. You'll find the perfection. You'll find everything you're looking for.
主 Shiva 告诉他，如果你去了 Mathura, 你就会找到你想要的一切完美。
So the Brahmana took this instruction in the dream of Lord Shiva, took it very seriously. He immediately left. He left Benares and he was walking to Mathura, and when he was on the way to Mathura, he came to another holy place called Prayag.
这婆罗门就非常认真地接受了主 Shiva 在梦中给他的训示，于是他立刻启程离开 Kasi, 就朝着 Mathura 走去。但是在路上，他来到了一处地方，名字叫 Prayag.
Prayag is known as the king of holy places because it's at Prayag where the Ganga meets the Yamuna.
Prayag 被称为圣地之王，在这个地方，恒河与雅穆纳河交汇在一起了。
And when he came there at that time,There were hundreds of holy men who were all there bathing in the Ganga, and it was in the month of Magh. The month of Magh means January, February. It's a winter time.
当他来到 Prayag 的时候，发现那里有成千上万的圣人们在这个河中沐浴，因为这时候正是 Magh 月份，也就是一二月。冬季。
So they were all bathing in the early morning, at the time at dawn, they were all bathing in the Ganga there, chanting their prayers.
所以就在这个冬季呢，这些圣人们就在河中沐浴，就在河中唱诵着神圣的祷文诗歌。
So, He saw them all offering prayers and offering obeisances, and they were having kirtan, and many of them had tilak on, Vaishnava tilak, and they were wearing flower garlands from the deities.
他看到了这些人呢，他们在念诵着祷文，并且顶拜，而且还举行了 kirtan 齐颂圣名，而且他们额头上画着 tilak, 颈上戴着供奉给神像的鲜花花环。
And of course, some of the devotees were dancing very ecstatically, and they were shouting out the names of the Lord, like Rama and Krishna, and they were showing great ecstasy.The Brahmana was very surprised. He'd never seen anything like this before.
而且这些人呢，他们在狂喜当中翩翩起舞，嘴里喊着 Rama Krishna 的名字。这个婆罗门因为以前从没目睹过这样的奇妙景象，所以大吃一惊。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, I'm here.
Oh, okay. Voice is breaking sometimes.
Yes.
Okay, he also saw that they had They were worshipping the deity of Bindu Madhava, a deity of Lord Vishnu, which is there on the bank of the Ganges.
他看到呢，这些人还崇拜了，宾都玛德瓦神像，也就是在恒河岸边的这个，威士努的一个神像。
Lord Chaitanya had given instruction to Rupa Goswami when he came to this place.
当主 Chaitanya 来到这个地方的时候，就在这个 Prayag 教导了 Rupa Goswami.
So the deity has been established. The deity has been there for a very long time.
因此，这尊神像呢是非常古老的神像。
So anyway, the Brahmana was just amazed when he saw these people, all the devotees. He didn't know that these are the Vaishnavas, and he was asking them. You know, he said, "You know, why do you fall on the ground like this? You know, like a,when you offer obeisances." He hadn't seen people do this before. He said, why are you falling on the ground? And why are you all singing like this so loudly and dancing like this? What's happening?
这个婆罗门他非常的惊讶于这些景象，因为他以前从来没见过人们就是这样倒在地上，他不明白他们在做什么，于是他便问他们，你们这样倒在地上在做什么，而且这些人还唱的声音还这么高声，并且他们还在跳舞，他不明白。
Why don't you calm down and become more peaceful? Why do you make such a noise? What is the ceremony you're doing? Who are you worshipping?
你们为什么不平静下来呢？你们为什么制造这些噪音？你们为什么不做些仪式呢？
So some of the devotees, they laughed at him when he spoke like this. But others, some of the other devotees got angry and said, "Oh, you fool, just be quiet, shut up."
于是呢，有一些奉献者呢，便开始笑话他的问题，还有一些奉献者呢，对他这个问题感到很气愤、愤怒，就对他说：“愚蠢的人呐，你快闭嘴吧。”
But there were some devotees there who were kind to the Brahmana, who tried to give him instruction to teach him what they were doing.
还有一些奉献者就对这个婆罗门心生怜悯，就好心的告诉他，教导他。
And so they told him that, you're the son of a Brahmana, and you don't know what we're doing.
他们就对他说，你是一个婆罗门的儿子，难道你不知道我们正在做什么吗？
You should never speak to devotees of Vishnu like this.
你永远不应该对威士努的奉献者说出这样的话。
You should understand, you know, that we're the devotees of Vishnu. We're not just ordinary people like in the material world. We're devotees. We've devoted ourselves to the worship of Lord Vishnu.
我们是威士努的奉献者。你永远不应该对主威士努的奉献者这样说话。你本来应该知道我们的。
You shouldn't tell us to stop making that noise. We're not just singing. We're not just ordinary singers. We're not just actors. We're worshipping. This is how we worship the Lord under the directions of our guru.
你不应该告诉我们停止这些噪音，不要把我们都当成普通的演员和普通的歌唱家，我们是以这种方式在崇拜着主。
Yeah, we've all been initiated as Vaishnavas from the, by the authorized teachers, and they instruct us how to worship the Lord.
我们都是受到启迪的 Vaishnava, 都是在咕噜迅速下做这个事儿的，而且是经过授权的。我们就是以这样的方式在崇拜着主。
So the Brahmana, this Brahmana who had asked these questions, he'd been chanting the Gopal mantra, but he didn't have any guru, he didn't have any pure devotee to guide him.
这个婆罗门他一直在唱诵着这个曼陀罗，但是呢，他并没有得到一个咕噜启迪，也没有得到一纯粹奉献者的联谊。
So the Vaishnavas told him, they said, we are worshipping the Lord in his different forms, just like he comes as Lord Nrisingadev. Some devotees worship Lord Nrisingadev, and some worship the Lord as Lord Ramachandra, and some worship him as Gopal. Or you could say Gopal means Krishna, the cowherd boy.
这些人呢都是主 Vishnu 的奉献者，有的人在崇拜 Nrisimhadev， 还有的崇拜的是 Ramachandra， 还有的崇拜是 Gopal， 也就是 Krishna 以牧牛童形式显现的
主。Right, these Vaishnavas, they worship Vishnu as the supreme Lord.
这些 Vaishnava 把 Vishnu 当成至尊主来崇拜着。
And they worship all the different avatars which come from Vishnu, like Kurma and Varaha and Vamana.
他们崇拜着主的不同的化身，比如说 Kurma 龟化身， Vamana 侏儒化身，
Varaha
Varaha 雄猪化身。
These different forms. These devotees were worshipping him. So the Brahmana heard this, he felt ashamed, you know, hearing this, he felt ashamed, he understood his ignorance. So very humbly he asked them, they said, where does this Lord live?
这个婆罗门听了这些 Vaishnava 的教导之后呢，就是感到很羞愧。他为自己的无知感到很难为情，于是他便谦卑下来，就问道，那我应该到哪里去寻找这位至尊主呢？
And he said, can you tell me what is he like and what kind of benefits is he able to give us?
你们能不能好心的告诉我，他长得什么样子，崇拜他又有什么好处呢？
Because generally people, when they worship a deity, they worship for some material desire.
有的人他崇拜神像是怀着得到物质好处的动机在崇拜着。
So the Brahmana thought these Vaishnavas must also have some kind of material desire.
于是这个婆罗门便断定这些 Vaishnava 们也是有着物质动机在崇拜着。
So the Vaishnavas answered the first question, he wants to know where does he live. They said, well, he lives everywhere. He's within everything and he's outside of everything.
这些 Vaishnava 开始回答婆罗门的第一个问题，他居住在哪里？他们说他无处不在，他在一切事物之内，而且在一切事物之内又在一切事物之外。
Yeah, he's the supreme.There's no one equal to him.
他是至高无上的，他是天下无双。
Right. In the material world, we are very limited. We can only be in one place at one time, and then we move from one place, we go to another place. But this Lord, Vishnu, he's everywhere.
我们都是有限的，我们只能在某个时间某个地点来存在着，从一个地方挪到另外一个地方，但是这位 Vishnu 却是遍存万有的。
He's not an ordinary person. He's everywhere and at all time is everywhere.
这位 Vishnu 不是普通的人物，他无处不在，他遍透万事万物。
And all other people and everything is a part of him.
而且其他的一切的事物和人，所有的生物都是它的所属部分而已。
Then he wanted to know what is he like. So the Vaishnava said, well, he's very special. There's nobody equal to him. He's very, very beautiful.
关于他的第二问题，他长得什么样子？这些 Vaishnava 回答说，他非常的相貌独特，在天下没有人长得像他那么美丽英俊。
And he has so many wonderful qualities that nobody can compare to him.
他还拥有，许多的美好的品质，没有什么人能够比拟这些品质。
He's in the heart of every living being.
而且他居住在每一个生物的内心，
He's the supreme in the universe.
他是宇宙之中至高无上的人物。
His form is full of eternity knowledge, is full of eternity knowledge and bliss.
他的形体是永恒，充满知识和极乐的。
And he lives in the, his home, his he lives in the Vaikuntha in the spiritual world.
他居住在他的家，外昆塔灵性的世界。
And if we go there, you can see him there all the time.
如果你去了那里，你就能随时能见到他了。
And he's very kind to his servants. He will give everything for his servants.
他对他的仆人非常仁慈有加的，他会给他的仆人一切。
So this is the nature of Lord Vishnu, Lord Vishnu is the super soul in the heart of everyone.
这就是维什诺的本质，他居住在每一个众生心中，以超灵的形象居住在那里。
He's not only in the heart of every living entity, he's the super soul of the entire universe.
他不仅是每一个生物众生的超灵，而且是全宇宙的超灵，
And all the universes are under him.
而且所有的宇宙都处在他的控制之下。
So this way the Vaishnavas are explaining about the Lord whom they worship.
就这样，这些 Vaishnava 描述着他们崇拜的这位主。
Yeah. And when he asked what is he able to give us? The Vaishnava said he will give his own self to us.
有关于他的第三个问题，他能带给我们什么？然后这些 Vaishnava 回答说，他能把他自己给予我们。
He won't just only give you the, you know, in the material world there are four goals, but he won't just give you those, he'll give you more than that.
他不仅能给予物质世界的四个目标，而且能给予超越这四个目标之外的好处。
Material world people are interested in opulence. So the Lord, he won't just give you opulence of the material world, but he can give you spiritual opulence.
在物质世界的人们都追求富裕，但是这位主他不仅能给予物质富裕，而且能给予灵性的财富。
He can give us live. He can take us to the spiritual world. He can give us pure devotion. He can take us beyond birth and death.
他能把我们带到灵性世界，他能赐予我们纯粹的父爱，他能将我们超脱出生死轮回。
So then the Vaishnavas, they told him that. They told him that you should read the scriptures because the scriptures will tell you everything about him.
这些 Vaishnava 告诉婆罗门，你应该读经典，因为在经典当中就讲述了这一切。
Yeah, if you can, especially you can read the Puranas. Their Puranas mean the histories. So the histories, they will describe everything about the Supreme Lord and his different forms, his different incarnations.
尤其是应该读往事书，因为在往事书中就描述了至尊主他的形象，他的活动。
So then they brought him to see the deity of Lord Madhava, and they said, "You see, just bow down before Lord Madhava."
于是他们便将婆罗门带到了 Madhava 神像面前，就告诉他，你看到了吗？你应该在这尊神像面前顶拜。
This deity of Lord Madhava, he is the manifestation of the Lord of the universe. He's not different from the personality who's the Lord of the universe, who's the super soul.
这尊神像就是至尊主的展现，他跟众生心中的超灵是无二无别的。
So you have to take shelter of the deity here, and in this way you will come to know the Lord of the spiritual world.
你应该托庇于神像，这样你就能明白灵性世界的至尊主了。
We can tell you some things about the glories of the Lord, but if you take shelter of the deity, then it will help you so much to understand more the Lord.
我们可以给你讲述一些有关于至尊主的荣耀，但是如果你自己亲自托庇于神像，你就能了解这个神像和至尊主了。
Right, when you meditate on the deity, then you will get a lot of realization from the heart, because he's in the heart also. So he will help you to understand more his glories.
如果你冥想神像，就能获得觉悟，并且你能了解内心的至尊主，因为他就处在内心，你便能明白他的荣耀。
So the Brahmana had been chanting his mantra, and he had been meditating on Madan Gopal, and he could see that this Madhava, who he was seeing here at Prayag, the deity Madhava, who the Vaishnava showed him, who was Vishnu, that he looked like the person who he was worshipping in his mantra.
这个婆罗门他一直在念诵着马丹勾炮的神马丹勾炮的曼陀罗。因为他在冥想着这个曼陀罗，他觉得这尊神像 Madhava 神像，这个 Vaishnava 崇拜的这尊神像，就像他所崇拜的这个曼陀罗，吟诵这个曼陀罗所冥想的这个神像长得很相似。
But this Brahmana was a bit stupid. He could not understand actually they're the same.
这个婆罗门有一点愚蠢，他不明白他们是一个人。
He saw some features of the deity, that the eyes and the mouth, facial features, they looked very similar to the person who he was seeing when he chanted his mantra of Madan Gopal.
这婆罗门呢，他只是关注的这个神像的面容，他的五官，他的眼睛和口。他长得呢，就像他在念诵曼陀罗的时候所见到的这个神像马丹勾炮。
So while he was there at Prayag, at that place, at this the temple, he saw many different deities of Vishnu, and he was hearing also from the Puranas, from the scriptures.
婆罗门在 Prayag 期间呢，他就见到了 Vishnu 的许多神像，而且聆听了普拉纳往事书。
He was hearing how it's very powerful if you take bath at the Prayag, at the place where the Ganges meets the Yamuna. If you take your bath there in the early morning in the month of Magh, it's very powerful, it's very purifying, it destroys a lot of sins, and it helps us to get spiritual realization.
他听说呢， 假设人要是在Mark 就是一二月份呢，在 Prayag 恒河与杨的河交汇的地方沐浴，清晨沐浴，他就能获得，他能就是这个力量是非常巨大的，能摧毁一个人的巨大的罪恶反应。
And he was in an association of these devotees who were pure souls. They were pure devotees. They were Vaishnavas, but they were devotees of Vishnu.
而且婆罗门呢，就在跟这些纯粹的灵魂们联谊，他们都是主 Vishnu 的纯粹的奉献者。
But this Brahmana was not, he was not able to understand that actually Lord Vishnu and Lord Madangopal, who he was worshipping, are the same.
但是婆罗门他不明白的是，这些 Vaishnava 崇拜的 Vishnu 和他在念诵这个曼陀罗所显现给他的这尊 Madangopal 是一个人。
Yeah. He thought that this one who the deity of the Vaishnavas, that he thought must be different from the person who he was worshipping.
那他这个婆罗门呢，就觉得这些 Vaishnava 所崇拜的 Vishnu 和他所念诵曼陀罗崇拜的这个 Madangopal 不是一个人。
The Vaishnavas had told him, you know, that that deity of Vishnu, Madhava, Bindu Madhava, that that was the Supreme Lord. So he believed them, but he didn't know that the person who he was worshipping in his mantra was also the Supreme Lord.
婆罗门呢，他听这些 Vaishnava 说，这个Bindu Madhava, Madhava 神像是宇宙是至尊主。他这一点呢，他深信不疑，但是呢，他不明白他自己念诵曼陀罗的时候所崇拜的这个马丹勾炮也是至尊主。
Yeah, he saw the deity, this deity in Prayag, Bindu Madhava, he has four arms, you know, four arms of Vishnu, one arm holding the conch shell, and one with the club, and one with the disc, the Sudarshan Chakra, and another with the lotus flower.
他眼中所见到的这尊 Madhava 神像呢，他是四臂，分别拿着海螺、大头棒，还有莲花以及神杵，以及神碟。
Yeah, so he thought, this is not my deity. I don't worship a deity. My deity is not like this. My Lord does not look like this. My Lord only has two arms. It's different from this.
这个婆罗门心里想，这并不是我所崇拜的那个至尊主，因为他有四臂，而我崇拜的呢只有两臂。
And this form of Vishnu with the four arms, he appears sometimes in different forms. Sometimes he's a half lion, half man. Sometimes he becomes a dwarf.Sometimes he's a fish. He takes all these funny forms. My deity doesn't do like that.
这尊这个四臂神四臂的神像是至尊主，他有的时候呢，他显现为半人半狮形象，有时候是个侏儒形象，而有的时候是鱼化身，鱼的形象。我崇拜的这个至尊主并不是这样子的。
In this form of Vishnu, sometimes he also becomes a king like Lord Rama, and he'll have a bow in his hand. But my deity Gopal, he's not like this.
这尊神像呢，他有的时候又显现为一个国王 Rama Chandra, 手里拿着弓，而我的主呢，并不是这样子的。
But They do look, he had to admit, they do look a bit alike. There's some similarities.
但是他不得不承认的就是这两尊神像呢，他们有些类似，他们有些雷同之处。
So he was thinking, the Brahman thought, I don't believe that the deity I worship could be the Lord of the universe.
所以这个婆罗门就想， 我可不相信我崇拜的这个主他是宇宙之主。
He doesn't tell me to take bath in the Ganga in the winter time in the Ganges there. He doesn't tell me that. That's only for these Vaishnavas who are worshipping Vishnu.
婆罗门心里想，我的主可没有告诉我在冬季寒冷的冬季在恒河里沐浴，我的主没有命令我这样去做。
No, the deity I'm worshipping, he's a cowherd boy. Takes care of the cows in the forest with these other cowherd boys, and he's holding a flute to his mouth.
我崇拜的至尊主，他可是一个牧牛童啊！他和别的牧牛童一起去森林里放牧牧牛。
He's just like an ordinary person. He decorates himself with different things from the forest, like peacock feathers.
他就像个普通人那样，他会从森林里捡拾各种各样的装饰物，就比如说孔雀羽毛来装饰他自己。
And he doesn't follow he's not so particular about following the teachings of scriptures and religious principles. Sometimes he will play games with the cowherd girls, with the other young girls.
他对于遵守经典中的那些规范原则也不是非常严格，他还跟那些牧牛姑娘们一起玩耍嬉戏。
He's not like a saintly person who follows all the rules so carefully, so strictly.
他不像那些圣人们非常严谨小心地遵守着所有的规则。
No, he's always wearing garlands of, you know, because he's in the forest, so he has a garland sometimes of kadamba flowers, and he'll put his tilak with the red clay which they find in the forest.
我崇拜的这个主啊，他有的时候带着kadamba的花环。而且就从森林中可以找到的那些红粘土，用这些红粘土来涂他的 tilak。
So these Vaishnavas, they also worship Gopal, but they considered Gopal to be a form of Lord Narayan.
这些 Vaishnava 他们也崇拜 Gopal。但是他们认为 Gopal 是主 Narayan 的一个形象。
But the Brahmana thought, my Gopal cannot be the same as their Gopal.
这个婆罗门心里想，我的 Gopal 跟他们的 Gopal 不是一回事。
Their Gopal is Lord Narayan. Lord Narayan wouldn't go in the forest. He wouldn't be walking in the forest taking care of cows.
他们崇拜的 Gopal 是主 Narayan， 而 Narayan 可不会去森林里去照料母牛。
And Lord Narayan cannot break the rules of religion. He will follow them. Has to follow the rules of religion very strictly because he teaches these things.
他们崇拜的 Narayan 可不会打破宗教原则，而是非常严格的遵守。他自己所教导的宗教原则。
So the Brahmana thought, I'm very happy worshipping my Gopal. I feel happy to chant his mantra. I'm not going to give up my Gopal.
婆罗门想，我念诵我的Gopal 的这个神。曼陀罗的时候感到非常高兴，我可不会放弃我所念诵的这个曼陀罗，崇拜的这个 Gopal。
So the Vaishnavas, they may say, well, you know he's not the Supreme Lord, why are you worshipping him?
然后这些 Vaishnava 就问他，那你为什么要崇拜他呢？如果他不是至尊主。
But the Brahmana thought, well, no, I was worshipping Lord Shiva's wife, the goddess, And she told me to chant this mantra, so I'm following her teachings.
我在崇拜婆罗门，回答他，他们说，我崇拜着主 Shiva 的妻子，这个女神，而这个女神就告诉我这个曼陀罗呀。
And I feel happy chanting it, so why should I give it up?
我念诵这个曼陀罗，感到非常高兴，我为什么要放弃呢？
So he continued to chant his mantra. He would chant in on his own, away from other people. And because he'd been associating with pure Vaishnavas, it helped him a lot. He got a lot of spiritual benefit from that. And he began to see his Gopal. He began to see Gopal that he saw when he would chant his mantra. He would see the Gopal as a person.
那这个婆罗门他还继续的就是悄悄的一个人念诵这个他的曼陀罗，但是因为他与这些纯粹的 Vaishnava 们的联谊呢，他都得到灵性好处，于是在他念诵曼陀罗的时候呢，他能见到这个马丹勾炮作为人的形象。
So we see here the brahmanas, he's getting the benefit of association with devotees.
从这个历史当中呢，我们看到婆罗门因为跟纯粹的奉献者们联谊获得了好处。
He still hasn't got the instruction. He still hasn't got instructions and blessings of a guru, but he's getting association with devotees and it's helping him.
他到目前为止还没有得到一个 guru 的训示以及教导，但是他却得到了跟奉献者们联谊的好处。
Yeah, he didn't have a guru and he wasn't reading any shastra, but just because he was associating in a nice way with the other Vaishnavas, he made advancement.
他还没有得到一个 guru 的教导，也没有开始阅读经典，因为他以一种很好的方式与这些 Vaishnava 们联谊，他便得到了好处。
So he kept chanting his Gopal mantra and his heart became cleansed. He got rid of a lot of dirty things from his heart, and because he was meditating on the mantra very intentlyHe was able to see the Lord, just as if the Lord was actually present before him.
因为跟这些 Vaishnava 的联谊呢，他们的内心呢便逐渐净化掉了所有那些肮脏的事物。于是呢，他在念诵曼陀罗的时候呢，他冥想曼陀罗的时候，他就见到了他亲眼曾经见过的那个人。
And this would cause him, sometimes he would faint in ecstasy. And when he would wake up after fainting, then he would think, oh, I've lost all my time. I'm chanted all my mantras that I was supposed to chant. And he would feel sorry.
于是呢，他在念诵曼陀的时候，有时候会晕倒在地。等他再次清醒过来的时候呢，他就想，哎呀。我浪费时间了，我本来应该念诵曼陀罗，但是我却没有在那念诵曼陀罗。
So, you know, hearing that he was in that ecstasy and feeling that it was like he had experienced bhava or prema, but there was not real bhava and prema, it was only just a reflection of the real bhava and prema.
他感受了一些 Bhava 和 Prema, 一些狂喜，但是这不是真正的 Bhava 和 Prema, 只是 Bhava 和 Prema 的一个折射而已。
To experience real Bhava and Prema, he must come to the stage of having proper understanding of the Supreme Lord.
要达到正确的 Bhava, 真正的 Bhava, Prema 阶段，一个人必须对至尊主怀着正确的理解力。
So he would lament if he could not finish his chanting. He would try, he liked to chant as much as he could. He would chant a lot of mantras. And when he would faint, then he would lose time. He wouldn't be able to finish all the chanting.
他在念诵曼陀罗的时候呢，现在他会，经常的晕倒在地。于是呢，他便没有很多的时间呢，能够完成他想要的念诵的这些数量。
And he like that. He had a kept trying to keep his vow to chant a fixed number of times every day. Very important.
就像他的这个例子，一个人每天发誓念诵固定数量的曼陀罗，这一点是非常重要的。
So he felt very bad that if he couldn't finish all of his chanting in the one day.
因为他不能在一天当中呢完成他的念诵的数量，所以他内心的感觉很糟糕。
He was wondering, he thought, he said, I didn't feel tired. I don't know why I fell unconscious. I don't know. I wasn't asleep. I don't know why, how I could fall asleep. I wasn't tired. Maybe he thought I'd been attacked by a ghost.
他心里想，我并没有感到疲累，为什么我就睡过去了呢？会不会是有鬼魂袭击了我？
So one day, when he was doing his chanting, he saw Lord Madhava. And Lord Madhava gave him some instruction.
一天，他正在念诵的时候，他见到了 Madhava. Madhava 就给了他训示。
This Madhava, this is the deity.Who the Vaishnavas worshipped.
这尊 Madhava 正是那些 Vaishnava 所崇拜的神像。
And the Lord Madhava told him that you don't have to feel sorry. You don't. There's no reason for you to feel bad.
这个 Madhava 就告诉他，你没有必要感到难过，没有理由悲伤。
You should know that very soon your ambition will be achieved. You'll be able to achieve your ambition.
不久，你将会实现你的愿望和实现你的这个心愿。
So then the Brahmana remembered how Lord Shiva had told him to go to Mathura.
这婆罗门回想起主 Shiva 曾经命令他去 Mathura。
And he remembered how Lord Shiva told him like that. So he thought, yeah, this is what I should be doing. I have to go to Mathura.
他回忆起主 Shiva 的这个训示，于是便想，也许我应该去 Mathura.
So he decided to go off, to leave Prayag and go to Vrindavan, go to Mathura.
于是他便决定离开 Prayag, 启程前往 Vrindavan Mathura.
So the deity in the dream also told him that he should go. He should not get involved in any other things. He should just go straight to Vrindavan. And then he would get the real mercy of the Lord.
这神像还告诉他，他不应该再卷入任何的其他的事物，而应该直截了当的径直去稳达稳，这样他会就达到他的夙愿。
It's only by the mercy of the Lord. You don't get the not. You won't get real mercy from anybody else except the Lord.
除了至尊主之外，你不会从任何人那里得到仁慈。
So he went to Vrindavan, he came to the place. When you enter Mathura, there's a place, there's a holy place called the Vishrama Ghat. It's on the side of the Yamuna. And you take bath there when you first come to Mathura.
当他刚一进入 Mathura 的时候，他来到了一处名字叫 Vishramagat 的地方，就是在雅穆纳河岸边的一处地方。他于是便在雅穆纳河中沐浴了。
So he was happy, very, very happy to come there in Vrindavan, and he could see, he could feel the power, the purity of the place. It's a very special place.And he saw all the people there also, they're very special.
他很高兴能来到这一处特殊的地方，并且见到了当地 Mathura 的居民们。
Just like when he was meditating, in his meditation, he would meditate about Krishna's pastimes, and he would see cows and kadamba trees and cowherd boys and gopis.So he came to Vrindavan, he saw all these things real.
正像他在念诵曼陀罗的时候所见到了那些母牛、牛犊、Kadamba花树以及母牛姑娘，当他来到 Mathura 的时候，他亲眼见到了这一切。
So he was wandering around Vrindavan, he wasn't meeting any people.But at one place, he heard somebody crying.
他便在文达文四处漫游，他并没有停下来和任何人交谈，但是在一个地方，他突然听到了有的人在哭泣。
This was to be the first person he was to meet in Vrindavan, and he met him at a holy place. It was a place called Keshi Tirtha.Which is the place where Krishna killed the horse demon, Kesi.
这将是他在文达文所遇到的第一个人。这个地方名字叫 Keshi Tirtha, 也就是主 Krishna 杀死马魔的地方。
It said,The Yamuna is more sacred, more powerful than the river Ganga.
据说雅穆纳河比恒河更加的神圣。
And more sacred than Mathura is the place on the Yamuna where Krishna killed the Kesi demon.
而比Mathura 更神圣的是主 Krishna 杀死 Keshi 魔的地方。
And even more special, more powerful, more sacred than the place where Krishna killed the Keshi demon is the place where Krishna rested after he killed the demon.
比 Krishna 杀死 Keshi 魔马魔更神圣的地方是他。在杀死马魔之后停下休息的地方。
So he heard this, he was here at this place and he could hear someone crying. So he wanted to wonder what was happening, who was crying. He went to investigate.
所以于是当他听见有的人哭泣的时候，他便想去查看个究竟，为什么这个人会哭泣呢？
ButAs he got closer, he could hear the cry. He could hear there was also, they were doing chanting, they were doing sankirtan, they were chanting the holy name, and they were chanting the holy name with great love. It was, sounded very powerful, very pure, but at the same time, they were crying.
于是当他去查看究竟的时候呢，他发现不仅仅是有哭泣声，而且呢还有唱诵圣名的 Sankirtan 的声音，而且是怀着巨大的奉爱，非常纯粹的一颗心，以非常有力量的方式在唱诵着圣名。
Yeah, it was so attractive. The chanting was so powerful. He wanted to find out, oh, who is this? Who is doing this?
这个唱诵声音是这样有吸引力，是这样的有力量，与婆罗门便想去查看个究竟，到底是怎么回事呢？
So he entered into this forest. It was very, very thick forest. He could not see anything or anyone. And he entered into the forest and he came through the trees. He came to the bank of the Yamuna.
这个声音是从密林森林深处传来的，里面呢一片漆黑，什么也看不见。这是在亚木纳岸边的一处地方。
And there he found there were some kadamba trees. He found this very good-looking young man whose body was very, very tender, very soft.And he was dressed just like a cowherd boy.
他正朝那个地方走过去，发现一个相貌非常好看的一个年轻人，他的身体四肢非常柔软轻柔，而且他的穿着是非常的吸引人的。
Yeah, he had a flute and he had a buffalo horn.And he had peacock feathers in his hair, and he was just like a cowherd boy, and his body looked so auspicious. Everything was very, very wonderful about him.
这个人呢，他手里拿着笛子，并且呢，他带着水牛角，他还有孔雀羽毛，而且他看上去就是那么的吉祥。
So when the Brahmana saw him, the Brahmana thought that this cowherd boy thought this is his deity. And he called out, Oh, Gopal! And he fell down and offered obeisances to him. He thought this was actually his deity, Gopal.
那婆罗门见到这位牧牛童装扮的年轻人之后，以为是他的念诵曼陀罗崇拜的 Gopal 神像，他便立即向那个牧牛童敬拜，大呼 Gopal。
Because the Brahmana was just dressed just like the person in his mantra who is worshipping, who is meditating, so he thought he's Madan Gopal. The Brahmana had been worshipping Madan Gopal, and then he saw this cowherd boy, he thought this person was Gopal.So he called out, Gopala, and fell down, offered obeisances.
眼前这位年轻人呢，就像他崇拜念诵曼陀罗所崇拜的那个牧牛童，他的举止还有他的穿着相貌都和这个 Gopala 神像一模一样。于是呢，这个婆罗门便立即，顶拜，倒在地上顶拜。大声呼唤着 Gopal 了。
So the young man, the cowherd boy who'd been sitting there, he saw that this other Brahmana was coming, and so he stood up and he greeted him and he bowed to the Brahmana, and they embraced each other.
这个年轻人见到婆罗门向自己走过来，于是便起身，问候了婆罗门，也向婆罗门顶拜。
And the cowherd boy, he could understand that this man, this Brahmana was coming. He was actually was a Mathura Brahmana, and he was worshipping. He understood that he'd been worshipping Madan Gopal.
年轻人呢看到走过来的婆罗门，他是一个 Mathura 的婆罗门，于是他便明白这个婆罗门呢一直在崇拜着 Madan Gopal。
So this cowherd boy actually knew everything about the Brahmana.
这个牧牛童呢实际上对婆罗门了解的一清二楚。
The cowherd boy had been ordered that morning to go to the forest to do his meditation, to go there and wait there. But he'd been ordered by Radharani to do that.
这个牧牛童呢， 他是被 Radharani 指派着，就清晨去森林去等待着婆罗门到来。
So the cowherd boy wants to, he wanted to get the confidence of the Brahmana. He wanted the Brahmana to be ready to accept everything he would say.
这位牧牛童呢，他想取得婆罗门的信任，以便好接受他自己将要向他讲述的一切。
So the cowherd boy first of all pleased the Brahmana with hospitality. He made him feel very comfortable.
一开始牧牛童呢便对这个婆罗门呢彬彬有礼，让他感到宾至如归。
And then he began to tell the Brahmana something about the Brahmana's own life. So he wanted the cowherd boy to see the cowherd boy wanted the Brahmana to understand that he knew everything about the Brahmana from his life, his previous life.
接下来牧牛童开始讲述这个婆罗门的身世，以便让婆罗门知道他对这婆罗门的前世都很清楚。
The cowherd boy told the Brahmana things which ordinary people, nobody knew about him.
牧牛童向婆罗门讲述没有人知道的有关于婆罗门的身世。
He knew, he told the Brahmana what kind of family he came from, and he told the Brahmana about how he'd been worshipping this deity, of, he'd been worshipping Lord Shiva's wife.
牧牛童告诉了婆罗门他的父母，他诞生在什么样的家庭，以及他所崇拜的这个主 Shiva 的妻子，这尊女神的神像。
So the Brahmana was amazed that this cowherd boy knew everything about him.
这个婆罗门呢感到特别的惊讶，这个牧牛童竟然对他自己了如指掌。
So this cowherd boy is actually, his name is Gop Kumar.
这个牧牛童的名字叫 Gopal Kumar.
So the Brahmana immediately accepted this cowherd boy as a friend, and he trusted him.
婆罗门便立即把这个牧牛童当成自己的朋友，对他非常的信任。
And so then the Brahmana began to speak about his life, telling Gop Kumar everything about him.
于是婆罗门便向这个 Gopal Kumar 讲述他自己的经历，把一切都道出来了。
See, at first, the Brahmana was thinking that the cowherd boy was his deity, his worshipful lord, but now he understood he's a cowherd boy, but he has all very good qualities.
一开始，婆罗门以为这个牧牛童就是他所崇拜的这个神像，但是后来他明白他只是一个牧牛童，而且拥有着美好的品质。
So the Brahmana understood that the cowherd boy had a lot of knowledge that he could learn a lot from him. So the Brahmana put some questions to him.
婆罗门明白到这个牧牛童拥有着大量的知识，于是便向牧牛童奉上了一些问题。
So the Brahmana said to the cowherd boy, Gop Kumar, he said to Gop Kumar that I've been meeting people and I've been learning about different paths and different methods, but I can't decide which is the best one and which one I should try to follow.
婆罗门对牧牛童说，我一路上见到了各种形形色色的人，也并且了解了有不同的途径，但是我不知道我到底应该走哪条道路。
Right, but when he had been there at Ganga Sagar, there the Brahmanas had spoke about heaven as a goal.
当婆罗门去 Ganga Sagar 的地方，他被告知去天堂是人生的目标。
But then when he went to Benares, the sannyasis were telling him, no, liberation is a goal, get free of birth and death.
最后他去贝纳勒斯的时候，当地的托钵僧又告诉他，其实呢，解脱才是人生的终极目标，要摆脱生死轮回。
Some people were giving importance to karma, and others were giving importance to knowledge. So, which was important? He was confused.
有的人很强调 karma 果报工作的重要性，而另一些人强调 jnana 思辨的重要性，他不知道孰轻孰重。
So he's asking Gop Kumar, "Can you help me? Can you advise me what I should do?"
他便询问 Gopa Kumar，你能不能给我一些建议，告诉我到底该怎么做呢？
Okay, so we'll stop there.
好，我们就讲到这里。
Any questions?
Yes, Sati from Sati，怎样才能最大限度地得到与奉献者联谊的益处？How to get the benefit to the greatest extent the benefit of association with devotees?
We get the maximum benefit from association with devotees by hearing, first of all, by hearing from them, and by hearing and inquiring, by inquiring from them and hearing from them, and then trying to apply the advice, the instructions they give us.
我们首先是通过聆听以及询问奉献者得到最大的益处，接下来是通过把自己所聆听到的教导以及这些建议运用加以实践，从而最大的获益。
Just like we may hear, oh, chanting is very important. But if we don't chant much, then we don't take advantage of their teaching.
比如说，我们听说念诵是非常好的，但是如果自己不亲身去念诵的话，就得不到这好处了。
So it's important for us to try to apply what we hear from devotees.
同样重要的是把奉献者的建议应用到日常生活当中。
Any other question?
From Das，这个婆罗门与奉献者联谊已经看到主了，还有必要再得到灵性导师的指导吗？
Yes, because the goal of life is not just simply to see the Lord, just like this Brahmana, he saw the Lord, but he didn't know what to do, he didn't know how to relate to the Lord.
因为人生的目标不是看见主，人生的目标就像这个婆罗门，他虽然已经见到主了，他并不知道该接下来该怎么做，以及他该如何跟这个世界打交道。
So it's important to get the instruction of the devotees.
所以得到奉献者的教导训示是非常重要的。
Right? Even greater than it said, of all kinds of worship, the worship of Vishnu is the greatest.
据说在各种各类的崇拜当中，崇拜 Vishnu 是最高的崇拜。
But even greater than the worship of Vishnu is the worship of those things in relationship to Vishnu.
而比崇拜 Vishnu 更加伟大的是崇拜跟 Vishnu 有关的事物。
So we see in Krishna's pastimes, Krishna met people, not everybody surrendered to him.
在主 Krishna 的逍遥时光当中，也遇到各种各样的人，但并不是他们全都臣服了主 Krishna。
So the goal of life is not just to see the Lord, but it's to know how to relate to the Lord and how to surrender to him and how to love him.
所以，生命的目标不是见到主，而是怎样跟主建立关系，怎样去 臣服主，怎样去爱主？
So you need the guidance of devotees.
所以需要一位奉献者的，需要奉献者们的指导。
You need to have a spiritual master. We need to have guidance.
需要有一灵性导师来指导我们。
Yeah, another question.
From Rajendra Das, 感谢 Maharaj 的讲课。Krishna 满足取悦他的奉献者的灵性愿望，同时也满足物质愿望。这个满足物质愿望的目的何在？
Satisfying our material desires. What's the purpose of?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, we have some material desires. Sometimes we have to experience the frustration of these material desires. How these material desires don't actually bring us real happiness.
我们必须要亲身的能够体验到这个物质愿望它给我们人生带来怎样的挫败，物质愿望不能带给我们快乐和满足。
Sometimes we have to experience how much trouble there is in the material world, how it doesn't actually give us real happiness.
我们必须真正的体验和经历到物质世界的种种麻烦，以及所有这些不能给我们带来快乐。
Sometimes people think, if I was rich, I will be very happy, I'll be very satisfied. But then when they get a lot of wealth, then they experience how miserable it is, how it doesn't give any real happiness.
有的人一心就想，我要是有钱了，我一定会感到快乐与满足。但是呢，当他真正的有了钱之后，他才体验到有钱的痛苦和烦恼。
Yeah, you get the people, when you have money, the people come and they pretend to be your friend, but they're only thinking how to steal your money.
当你有钱之后呢，就会有人过来假装是你的朋友，他们一心只想把你的钱偷走。
They don't want you, they only want your money.
他们要的不是你，是你的钱。
So, we need to experience how our material desires won't make us happy.
我们必须有第一手的亲身经历，物质的愿望不会让我们快乐。
Sometimes Krishna arranges, he gives us that experience. And then it makes us more convinced to become more determined in spiritual practice.
Krishna 就会安排我们亲身的去体验这一切，并且让我们自己从而能够获得辨别力，下定决心该做什么。Next question.
Yeah.
From Sati, from Das. 当说到某个地方比另一个地方更神圣时，更神圣是什么意思啊？
Translate.
Yes. When you said that one place is more sanctified, more holy than the other place, what does you mean by this more sanctified, more holy?
Well, there are different degrees of spiritual purity, spiritual power.
灵性的纯洁度以及灵性的力量，它是有不同的程度的。
They're all holy places, but some holy places are more powerful than other places.
有各种各样的圣地，但是有的圣地比另外一个圣地呢更加神圣。
It means they, when it means more powerful, it means they can They can take away more sins, or they can give more purification.
它更加有力量的意思就是说，这样的圣地呢，能拿走更多的罪恶，以及give more purity， 并且能让一个人更加的纯粹。
Yeah, we should understand that there's variety. It's not all one.
我们知道应该有是各种各样的，种类，而不是都是一。
Just like there are different levels of devotees, pure devotees. Now some pure devotees may be Kanista Adhikari. They may be on the third level. Some pure devotees may be on the second level. And some pure devotees may be on the first level.
纯粹的奉献者呢，他也分为 Kanista Adhikari 初级奉献者，以及中级奉献者，以及高级纯粹的奉献者。
So the same way, holy places. Some places are more holy than others. It means they can give purification quicker and to a greater extent.
那么有的地方是圣地更加神圣的意思，就是这样的圣地能够更快速的净化一个人，并且让一个人更加的纯粹。
Yeah.
How can we see the former Lord when we chant Hare Krishna?
Well, we have to. You see, that's not the goal.The goal is not just to see Krishna, but if you have that desire, well, you know, we have to understand pure chanting is to chant for the pleasure of Krishna without these kind of desires.
那看到主的形象不是目标。但是尽管如果我们内心有这种愿望，我们要知道这不是纯粹的唱诵，纯粹的唱诵只是为了取悦主。
The pure devotees see Krishna in the holy name, that the name of Krishna is not different from Krishna.
纯粹奉献者在圣名当中见到 Krishna, 圣名与 Krishna 无二无别。
So when we chant the holy name without offense, we will come to realize that Krishna's name is not different from Krishna the person, and we will see Krishna in his name.
当我们毫无冒犯地唱诵圣名的时候，就会觉悟到 Krishna 就在圣名当中，我们就会在圣名当中见到 Krishna.
The holy name possesses within the name, there is also the form of Krishna.There are Krishna's qualities and Krishna's pastimes. It's all there within the name.
你在圣名当中见到的 Krishna, 他拥有所有的品质以及逍遥时光。当你在唱诵圣名的时候，你就能见到这一切。
So we will see Krishna when Krishna wants to reveal himself to us. It's up to Krishna.
当 Krishna 愿意的时候，我们就能见到 Krishna， 这取决于 Krishna。
Krishna has independence. We're the servants. We cannot order Krishna to come before us.
Krishna 是独立自主的，我们只是 Krishna 的仆人，我们不能命令 Krishna。
Our chanting mode has to be that mode of as a servant, that please engage me in your service.
我们的念诵应该是更处在这个服务的心态当中，请让我为你服务吧。
We shouldn't be thinking, when will Krishna come to see me? We should just be thinking, when will I be able to give pleasure to please Krishna with my service?
我们的想法不应该是说，什么时候我才能见到 Krishna， 我们的想法应该是什么时候我才能给 Krishna 带来快乐呀？
So Bhakti said, Prabhupada's spiritual master used to say, don't try to see Krishna, but act in such a way that Krishna may come to see you.
帕帕德的灵性导师曾经说过，不要试图去见 Krishna, 而应该以你自己的行为举止让 Krishna 能够乐意来见你。
So when will he come to see us? When he's pleased, when he feels it's necessary. If he feels it's necessary for us to see him, then he'll come.
那他什么时候会乐意来见我们呢？只有当他满意的时候，当他觉得有必要来见我们的时候，他就会能安排，能够让他自己见到我们。
Just like Narada Muni, before he became Narada Muni, in his previous life, he was the son of a maidservant.
正如 Narada Muni, 他的前世只是一个女仆的儿子。
So he had served the sadhus who had come to his home, and they taught him how to meditate.
所以他便有机会来服务那些到他家里的圣人们。而这些圣门便教 Narada 怎样冥想。
And after his mother died, then he left home and he wandered the world.
在他母亲去世之后， Narada 便离开家，在世界漫游。
And at a certain point, he sat down in meditation and he actually saw the Lord. And the Lord spoke to him.
在某一时刻，他便坐下来开始冥想。然后他就见到了主，但是刹那之间主又从他眼前消失了。
But then the Lord told him that you won't be able to see me again.
主跟他告诉他，你这一生再也见不到我了。
In this life, you won't see me again.
你在这一世，你再也见不到我了。
So the Lord is independent.He can choose when he comes, who he wants to reveal himself to, when he wants to reveal himself.
所以主他是独立的，是尊主，他可以选择何时显现以及向谁显现。
Our duty is just to serve. And in the Kali Yuga, we should understand the importance of seeing the Lord in his name.
我们的职责是服务，在卡里年代，我们要学习怎样在圣名，在他的名字中见到主。
So we associate with Krishna through the chanting of his holy name.
所以我们学习怎样通过唱诵圣名来与主联谊。
And we have to chant that name with love.And devotion.
我们需要怀着爱以及奉献来唱诵圣名。
Okay, any other question?
Next question from Vedavati Devadasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru, 感恩翻译。您讲到要获得 Bhava, 得到对主正确的理解力。那请问Guru, 什么是对主正确的理解力？
You
mentioned that before we get Bhava, we have to have the right understanding for the Lord. Then, the question is that, what does you mean by the right understanding for the Lord?Thank you, Guru.
Well, sometimes we see people come to the temple, you know, and they're new devotees, and they may cry, they may shed tears. They see the deities are in the temple room, and they may cry. They feel some, you know, some that shedding of tears is like some ecstasy, some kind of bhava. But they're new devotees, so they don't really have Baba, but they have some kind of shadow reflection of Baba.
有时候我们见到呢，在庙宇当中，有的新人一来了之后呢，他见到主的神像呢，就便哭泣起来了，看上去好像是一种狂喜，像是仿佛是一种巴巴，但是呢，这种并不是真正的巴巴，它只是巴巴的一种折射和一种反射。
So they have to learn the principles of devotional service. They have to understand the whole process of devotional service, and they have to apply themselves, study the philosophy, and learn about their relationship with Krishna.
所以他们应该学习所有的规范原则以及所有的方法程序，并且加以实践，并且了解哲学和他们与主之间的关系。
Then they can come to the proper understanding of Krishna.
之后他们就能达到对主的正确的理解力了。
We have to know about Krishna's identity, Krishna's energies, how Krishna creates. We have to learn about Krishna's qualities.
我们要了解 Krishna 的身份， Krishna 的种种能量， Krishna 的创造。
And we have to learn about our relationship with Krishna.
我们还要了解我们与 Krishna 之间的关系何在。
So this will give us a proper understanding to come to the real level of Baba and Prema.
这就是正确的理解力，之后我们才能上升到 Baba 和 Prema 阶段。
Understand? 明白吗？
明白吗？ Vedavati Devadasi, 明白吗？
Okay.Any other question?
Next from Rajendra Das. 这位婆罗门遵循主的道路，也是我们必须要追随和效法的道路吗？ So the way.
Yeah, go ahead.
The way this Brahman search for the Lord, is it also the path that we should also follow and...
Yeah, but you can see, for example, how he began with some faith, you know, just like the different stages of devotion are being described. Faith, he began with faith, and then we heard about how he got sadhu sangha when he came to Prayag. So adoshradata sadhu sangho, there's a verse that describes the different stages of bhakti. You begin with faith.You develop faith, and then you get association with devotees, and then from association with devotees, you learn how to do devotional service, bhajana kriya. Like that, so we can see that how the brahmana is coming to different, he's going through the different levels of self-realization.
我们看到就是在就是这个婆罗门的经历当中呢，他一开始是有信心，然后呢，他就经历了不同的阶段。他在普拉亚格又得到了那个奉献者的联谊萨图桑格，之后呢，他又就是有巴扎那奎亚，他又进行了奉献服务，所以呢，他就是经历了，就像在经典中所说的，奉爱服务的不同阶段。
So we've come immediately to bhakti. We shouldn't think, oh, I have to go back and do the other things. But from bhakti, we can learn about all these other things.
但是如果一个人他已经有 bhakti 的话，他就不需要再回头，再从头开始了。
We don't have to go back and do karmakandi activities.
Sorry, just a minute. I have to fetch my computer.
Yeah.
It's out of battery. Okay. Sorry, can you, pardon?
Yeah, I was saying that we don't have to go back to the lower levels. We've come to bhakti, we don't have to go back to the lower levels. But we can learn about them while we're in bhakti.
当我们已经处在 bhakti 风爱当中，我们不需要再回到低级阶段。但是我们在 bhakti 当中，我们可以学习所有这不同的这个种种这个阶段。
Just like we heard, he went to the Ganga Sagar and he met the Brahmanas, and the Brahmanas were talking about the goal of life to go to heaven.
就像我们在一开始听到的，就是这个婆罗门他去了 Ganga Sagar, 他和那个婆罗门联谊，当地的婆罗门就告诉他，去天堂才是人生的目标。
Now these Brahmanas were in the Murikutnas. They're very good, very pious people.
这些婆罗门他们都是非常善良的人，处在虔非常虔诚，处在善良形态。
But they're on the material platform, so devotional service is far above that.
他们处在的是物质的层面，而奉献服务远远超越了物质层面。
So one who is doing devotional service cannot be satisfied with these kind of material activities.
从事奉献服务的人永远不会对这些物质的活动心满意足。
But we should understand, you know, what they're doing.
但是我们应该明白自己在做的什么。
Just like the sannyasis and Kas and Banaras, they were talking the goal of life is liberation. So we know also about liberation.
而在贝纳勒斯的那些托钵僧们，他们只是谈论的是解脱，所以我们也对解脱有所了解了。
And we understand also about cultivation of knowledge. And when, you know, we know it takes a long time to cultivate knowledge.
我们也对培养知识略知一二。我们就明白了，培养知识要花费很长的时间。
And you still only come to the path to the level of liberation, which is only the beginning of devotional service.
培养知识最终达到的是真达解脱的层面，而解脱只是奉爱服务的初期阶段，刚开始。
So we don't have to waste our time in other things, but from the point of Bhakti Yoga, we can look back and understand that all of these things are included in Bhakti Yoga.
所以我们不用浪费时间来回头经历这一切，但是呢，我们在奉爱当中也可以回顾所有这一切，了解奉爱。
Just like one has $100, he also has $10, he also has $50, it's all included.
就像一个人有了100美金，他也有了10美金、50美金，都包括了。
So one who's actually doing bhakti yoga, he knows about all the lower levels of yoga.
一个已经达到奉爱瑜伽层面的人，他了解瑜伽的低级层面。
Mm-hmm. Another question?
Another question. Radha Nanda. Hare Krishna, 深深顶拜敬爱的 Guru. 哪些品质能支撑我们去做基本的苦行呢？感谢翻译，感谢您。What qualities can...support us to do some basic tapasya?
Well, the desire, if you just have the desire to do it, then that will help you to do austerity.
愿望，如果你有想做苦行的愿望，就能支撑你做苦行。
Just like if you make a vow,I'm going to fast on a codicy. I'm going to do full fast on a codicy. And you make the vow the day before a codicy. You say, tomorrow on a codicy, I'm going to do full fasting. So you know, you're determined. You're not going to eat. You forget about it.
就向我们发誓，第二天我在伊卡德西我要全戒。所以头天晚上，那你就发下这个誓言，做好准备了。于是到了伊卡德西那天呢，你就有这个决心戒食戒水了。
So that's very important that you have to you want to do something. You're determined. You want to do it. So that will help you to cultivate the mood of austerity, tapasya.
所以决心就能帮助你去处在这个正确心态当中去从事一些tapasya苦行。
We have to have some determination also. We have to be, you know, fixed that we're not going to give up easily, that we really want something of a strong desire. We won't give up.
我们必须有决心，而且呢，非常的坚定，一心一意的，这样我们就不会轻易的放弃了。
Just like when we take initiation, we make vows.
就像我们启迪的时候也发誓。
We make vows. I'm going to follow these principles. I'm going to do this chanting. So after we make that vow, we should be very careful that we want to keep this promise. We want to strictly follow this.
就是启迪的时候我们发誓遵守四项原则念诵十六圈，那么之后呢我们就会要很小心的去要保持我们的誓言，去实现我们的誓言。
So to do austerities we have to understand also that the austerity should be done for the pleasure of KrishnaWe don't just do austerity to think of ourselves as being better than other devotees or a great devotee, but we do austerity for the pleasure of Krishna.
我们做苦行是为了取悦 Krishna. 我们做苦行不是为了成为更好的奉献者，比别的奉献者都强。我们应该是为了取悦 Krishna 来从事苦行。
So austerity in Krishna consciousness is doing things like going out to distribute books. It's a great austerity. Trying to preach to sinful people like Jagai and Madhai.
在 Krishna 世界中的苦行呢，就是出去派书，还有像。扎盖马代这样的罪恶的人传教。Next.
Yeah.
云云，顶拜您，请问我们每天是不是24小时都要建立在服务 Krishna 的爱的关系中？才算永远处在 Krishna 直觉中。The question that should we 24 hours a day we are fixed in our relation, loving relation with Krishna? Does that mean that we are fixed in Krishna consciousness?
Yes.Yes, definitely. If 24 hours a day you're thinking about your loving relationship with Krishna, that's Krishna consciousness.
是的，如果你24小时都sorry, the question is that this is two questions. Should we establish our loving relationship?With Krishna, 24 hours a day. This is the first question. And the second is that, so is it accounted as the way eternally in Krishna consciousness?
Well, Yes, we should try to establish our relationship with Krishna 24 hours a day.
是的，我们每天24小时都要建立在服务 Krishna 的爱的关系中。
Just like working for Krishna, you go to job, okay, I'm working for Krishna. And you come home, you have a family, you see your family also, it's also for Krishna, in Krishna consciousness. And you take rest at night, you sleep, so you can serve Krishna the next day.
那么比如说你工作，然后你就去为 Krishna 去上班，等你回了家，然后呢，你就把你这个家也是为了 Krishna， 处在 Krishna， 这也是处在 Krishna 之中。等你晚上休息的时候，你是为了第二天更好的服务 Krishna。
Try to keep ourselves in Krishna consciousness 24 hours, all day and night, yeah.
就这样的，我们一天24小时，整日整夜的处在 Krishna 之觉中。
And our relationship with Krishna is, he's the master and we are the servant.
我们跟 Krishna 的关系是，他是主人，我们是仆人。
So that is Krishna consciousness.
这便是称为 Krishna 之觉。
With seeing everything in relationship to Krishna.
我们看的万事万物都跟 Krishna 有关联。
Yeah, the home is also Krishna's home. We're his servant there.
这个家是 Krishna 的家，我们只是 Krishna 的仆人。
And we're cooking for Krishna because.Krishna is a person and he has to eat, so we cook for him.
我们还得为 Krishna 来做饭，因为 Krishna 是人，他也要吃饭呢。
So we want to do everything in Krishna consciousness.
所以我们希望能在 Krishna 之觉中呢，做每一件事。
Right, what was the first question?
The first question that she asked,Should we establish our loving relationship with, to serve Krishna 24 hours every day?
Yes, there are no days off, no holidays from Krishna's service.
是的，没有假日，没有一天是不服务 Krishna 的。
And the second part, question?
The second is that, so in this way, we are...Fixed in Krishna consciousness. Is that right?
Yes, that's right. Yeah. Yes, everything for Krishna. Everything in Krishna's service.
所以一切都是为了 Krishna. 一切都是处在对 Krishna 的服务中。
Right? Without, just like they have this, the shop.It doesn't close. It's open 24 hours, 7 days a week. So our devotional service is like that.
就像有一些商店24/7，一天24小时，然后每周七天都开放。我们对 Krishna 的服务呢，也是这样子的。
Then, another question.
云云。侮辱，请问 Krishna， 请问 Krishna 对我们的计划是不是永恒不变的，还是也是动态变化的呢？也取决于我们的自由愿望而变化。The question that, Krishna's plan for us, is this plan, eternal and changeless, or it is changeable, flexible, and depend on our own.Will change.
Krishna's plan for us is to bring us back home, back to Godhead. Back home, back to Godhead, we have our place there.
Krishna 对我们的计划就是把我们带回家，带回神手。我们在那里有我们的家。
We have a spiritual identity, and our place, our job, our You know, it's there, it's waiting for us to go back.
我们在那里有我们的身份，我们在那里有我们的地方，有我们的工作，在那里就等待着我们。
So is it changeable? No, that eternal position in the spiritual world doesn't change.
在灵性世界的那个位置是永远不变的，永恒不变的。
But we may try to do other things. We're given independence.
但是我们自己呢，也许在努力做别的事情。我们有自己的独立性。
So that's why we're here in the material world.
所以我们就来了物质世界了。
So here in the material world, you have free will. We can choose Krishna or Maya.
在物质世界。您有您的自由意志，可以选择 Krishna 或者选择 Maya。
When we select Maya, then we're put under the control of the three modes of nature.
如果我们选择了 Maya, 我们就被置于物质自然三属性的控制之下。
And we're forced to act in different ways by our karma.
We are forced to act in different ways by our karma.
According to our past activities and our past desires, we have certain things we want to do.
那么在我们根据我们以往生生世世的活动和欲望，我们就会有不同的活动，我们就会被迫来相应的采取行动。
Past association influences our activity.
过往生生世世的涟漪影响着我们的活动。
So we are thinking I'm free. We are thinking I can do what I like, but actually we're not free. We're controlled.
我们以为我们是自由自在的，想要怎么做就怎么做，但实际上我们不是自由的，我们是被控制着的。
Controlled by the material energy.
是被物质能量控制。Next question.
Yeah.
请问咕噜，佛家梵歌中，人有出身，不同阶层，在现代还有这个阶层吗？谢谢咕噜翻译。In Bhagavad Gita, it said.That the people have their own birth and they have their own caste. So, in the modern society, the caste system, the caste also exists in modern society?
Not in reality. Some people may claim that they're this caste, they belong to this caste, but it's not really present.It's just something which they, you know, they may say I'm a Brahmin by caste, but it's not really important. It's not doesn't mean anything today.
它不是真正的存在。有的人可能声称自己处于什么样的阶层，它只是一种说辞而已，并不重要。
But we see in every society there are these different kinds of divisions.
但我们在见到呢不同的社会当中确实也有这些划分。
There's the intellectual class, there's the administrative class, there's the business class, and there's the worker.
有知识分子阶层，有管理阶层，有商贾阶层，还有劳工阶层。
So these four divisions are there naturally within any society all over the world.
那在全世界各地呢，这些社会划分呢都是自然而然的。
But if people claim they belong to this caste by birth, then it doesn't mean anything. Has no meaning.
如果有人声称他是出生就属于哪种哪个阶层的话，这个他这个声称没有什么意义。
Somebody says, I'm a Brahmana, but they're working in the butcher shop.
有的人声称他是一个婆罗门，可是却在一个那个屠夫的商店里的工作。
So, does not mean anything.
他的这个说辞没什么意义。
Yeah, another question.
It's a comment from
好，
Das。非常感谢 Maharaj 精彩的回答和马大吉的翻译，谢谢。And next, Jivananda，感恩 Guru 的超然的讲述，讲述的如此详细。明确了修行 Krishna 直接的方向，谢谢您，真诚的顶拜您。搜索。
common, yeah.
Yeah。
Okay, any question?
没有其他问题了，Good day。
没有其他问题了。
没有，No question。
Okay, so let me stop here today.
Okay。
So thank you very much, Gunam Mani.
Thank you, Mark, for your wonderful lecture.
Very kind of you to help me here.
It's my.
Sandy, you.
Yes.
Okay, they closed the temple in Mayapur now. They don't want any devotees to go to Mangalarti, Vaman Bunakchu Mangalarti, Vaman the Bojava Tangka, Vaman Yeshe Shangwang Tangka, Vaman Bukhe Damiao Tingka, Vaman Mega Function, so those are Tamadosai Fangsali. Mayapur being Changjaya, Tingasha.
是的，现在
所以，
国外都已经很紧张了。好的，马拉志。好，那我们非常感谢，古鲁马哈拉志的讲课，然后您也多多保重。好，那也非常感谢 Guru Mahani Mandaji 的翻译，我们就到这里结束吧。